Hey guys, I just wanted to go over with you really quickly some of the sex link traits, because it's kind of a fun thing to talk about and think about, and it's something that you need to know. Okay, so remember that females inherit two X chromosomes, so this would be a female. Males inherit an X chromosome and a Y chromosome. So a lot of times you'll actually see that males are affected much more by genetic disorders than females are. And the reason is because females have two X chromosomes, so if it's a recessive disorder, then they have the ability to inherit one gene that doesn't have the affected disorder on it. Males, if they inherit that affected recessive X chromosome, they don't have another X to balance that out. So they either have it or they don't. Okay? Most of those genetic disorders are going to be found on the X chromosome, just so you know, but that's why the males actually show those traits more often. So I'm going to do a couple of Punnett squares with you, and I'm going to use color blindness for a couple different reasons. One, that is one of the well-known sex-linked traits. A lot of people actually inherit color blindness, and my husband is colorblind. So I'm going to do a couple Punnett squares, and we're gonna figure out the probability of my kids being colorblind. Okay? So I'm going to put at the top, Tim is a boy, I hope. So we're going to do X, Y, because he's male, and he does have the colorblind gene. Remember, it's recessive, so I'm going to use a subscript to denote the recessive trait, okay? And I'm going to use B for blindness. I don't think that I have that trait at all, because nobody in my family is colorblind. Nobody in my blood inherited family is colorblind. So I believe my genotype is X big B. Okay, so now all we have to do is fill in the Punnett square just like you've been doing and figure out what the chances of any of my children being colorblind, okay? So this one is gonna be XX. So she's gonna be a female, and she's gonna inherit a big B and a little B. So that means she's a carrier, okay? So she's a female carrier. And all that means is that she's carrying that gene even though she doesn't show it. So she has a chance of passing that on to her offspring, but this female is not colorblind, okay? I'm gonna do this one. She's also female carrier. All right, this one's gonna be a boy because he gets my X chromosome and Tim's Y chromosome. And since I'm passing on the dominant trait, he won't be colorblind. So male, unaffected. And this one's also going to be male, unaffected. So a genotypic ratio would look like we have two offspring that are female carriers to two offspring that are male unaffected. Okay? So if I asked you, what are the chances of my offspring being colorblind, with this Punnett square, it shows that the chances of my children being colorblind are 0%. Okay? But Kennedy is a carrier. So let's do a Punnett square showing the probability of Kennedy's offspring having that, showing that recessive trait. Okay, so this is Kennedy. And let's say she marries a boy that is not colorblind. I'm already marrying off my daughter and she's only three. Okay, so this Punnett square, this would be a female that's unaffected, so she does not have the colorblind trait. This one is heterozygous, so we say that she's a carrier. So she's not going to be colorblind, but she's going to have the ability to pass on that colorblind trait. unaffected male because this one gets that dominant gene, but this little guy is going to be colorblind. So she has a 25% chance of having a child that has that colorblind gene. Or if you're just looking at boys, she has a 50-50 chance, 50% chance of her little guys being colorblind, okay? So I'm going to give you another Punnett square, and I want you to work it out in your notes, and you're gonna take a little quiz after you watch this video, and one of the questions is gonna be involving this new Punnett square. So let's say Kennedy marries a boy that is colorblind. I want you to figure out, do the Punnett square and figure out what are her chances if she marries a colorblind boy of having offspring that are also colorblind. If you have any questions or you get stuck on anything, definitely come by and see me, or you can email me, or you can leave a note on Edmodo, and I will make sure that I cover that information when I see you guys on Friday.